Hey, welcome back into today's video. Sarah has finally spoken out, but the statement was released on Onision's channel. Onision then made a video that was very condemning. It had some very strong accusations against Madison and Ayalla. Well, I reached out to those girls and got a statement in reference to that, and we put it in this video. If you guys have been keeping up to date with this, we've been following the news on this, so make sure that your subscribe and notifications turned on. Let's get into this. He posts a picture of Madison, then says Onision ended his friendship with this girl for repeatedly trying to be in a relationship with him and his spouse, despite him having no interest in her, cheating on her boyfriend with his boss at Fred Meyer, and going behind Onision's back to trash talk him while pretending to be his friend. Not long after Onision cut ties with her, she decided to connect with a girl who cheated on Onision and gather dirt from the very same girl Onision dumped for cheating on him with. He is referring to Shiloh. Onision and his ex started dating legally, consensually. However, this girl lied to everyone and told everyone that Onision had dated her when she was younger than the age she was. And here are those receipts. Here are the receipts between him and Madison. Onision will be in blue. Unfortunately, we're going to have to sue you for slander. Best of luck to you. She says, okay, I will press charges for this then. He says, for what? She then sends the legality about recording somebody without their consent, which is illegal. He says, like I said, there is no recording of your voice without consent. We are going to have to sue you, however, as there is a recording of you publicly slandering me. She says, you stated out loud verbally to me that you were presently recording me. If you deleted it, then great. But you verbally stated to me on the phone call you were recording me. Be my guest, I don't have an effing dime, so you won't get anything out of it but paying for your own legal fees. And what I said wasn't untrue. He responds with, you were informed on the phone that you were wrong about Shiloh's age. You need to publicly state that. You also implied I was a pedophile. You need to retract that statement as well. Otherwise, we have to sue. It's our only option. She says, I'll speak to Shiloh and I'll say what ends up being the truth. If I was wrong, I will happily state that. I already publicly retracted the statement regarding you being a pedophile multiple times. But have you retracted yours regarding Shane Dawson? No. Have you retracted your comments regarding me about being a sexual predator toward you and your family? No, you have not. He says, please watch the documentary I made on Shane. It proves you're wrong. Also, I never called you a sexual predator. You are wrong about that as well. And I thought it was very interesting, though. He says, watch the Shane documentary and you'll see, but we all watched the Shane documentary and I personally did not see anything in there compelling enough to say Shane Dawson was a pedophile. Also, he says that he never said anything about her being a sexual predator, but there are these screenshots that exist. These were text messages released by Onision publicly. They say, then you started suggesting to Laney that you wanted to be our third, which made me sick to my stomach. You even said perverted things to me when recording, like that cage scene where you made an inappropriate comment to me when you were changing outside. I don't even know how many times you told Laney and I you wanted to be with us, but you just didn't take a hint. I wanted to work with you, not to be in a relationship with you. I will put this in the description below. It's very interesting that he would post these but without any context. And a lot of this throughout this video, they factually do not have any context to them, but we will provide our own. She goes on to say, you want me to dig out the text you decided to publicly tweet about me? Also, why would you be in contact with a self-admitted pathological liar, my ex of over 7 years? Do you not see how weird and inappropriate that is? I broke up with her for cheating on me. Then I end your and my friendship, refuse to work with you, and this is what you do. Like I said, I never called you what you say I did. However, I do have proof you slandered me heavily, retract completely or we sue, and you need to retract it on the same place you accused me on, both the drunken peasants and wherever else you wrongly accused me. She says, do not contact me again. He said, expect to hear from my lawyer. So you can see that he repetitively threatened her with being sued, threatened her with a lawyer. She then says, I retracted my statement at your request. Please please do not contact me again. He continues to talk to her after being told the second time, please do not contact her. He says, unless you completely retract the implications that I was ever with a 16-year-old, and also retract the statement's implications that you believe I am a pedophile on both the Drunken Peasants and Twitter, as well as anywhere else you said, I will still be pursuing you legally, making an example out of people. Now, this is really strange because I've often, in my research, I've seen him say to many people that he is going to pursue them legally. He's going to sue them, but it's never happened, and that really bothers me. It's like the boy who cried wolf, where he says he's going to do something, but at this point it looks like he's just strong-arming. He's just saying these things to scare these young women. He then takes the shot about her retracting the statement and says, you made a public false claim about Onision and admitted it was false, yet the damage is done. People continue to believe her lies despite the fact she admitted she did not tell the truth. But that's not what happened. We literally just read the conversations. At not one point did she say it was not true, but that she was going to retract the statements because she was being threatened by legal action. That doesn't mean that she said that this is proof. She did not deny the claims. So why did it just pick up at, I'm going to sue you for slander? It really had no context at all, and that was bothering me. So I reached out to Madison to get a statement about this so we could provide further context and I could present it to you guys so you could form your own opinions on this. This is what Madison had to say. So essentially, his ex-girlfriend Shiloh and I became friends after Greg told lies publicly about me. Someone sent her Instagram to me. I waited a few days to decide and finally reached out. I finally had someone I could vent to about Greg for the first time, because none of my friends ever met him and saw the side of him that I did. We talked about everything she went through with Greg. Not all of it was public. I didn't know what was and what wasn't. I assumed her age when they started dating was not public information. I was told she was 16 years old. So when I went on Drunken Peasants, I had half a beer. I was not drunk. I was 100% sober, and Billie was defending Greg so passionately, I was angry. I stated something along the lines of me knowing that he has had relationships with younger women, and I stated that he had pedophilia-like connotations. That was my exact phrasing. Didn't straight call him a pedophile because I knew that legally he was not, but I used that term because it was my personal opinion. I felt it very close to being that way. Real Stream News, the YouTube channel, then took that part of the stream, did a video on it, and embellished the story, twisted my words, and claimed that I stated I had information on Greg being a pedophile, but I was hiding it and covering it up. I woke up to Greg having unblocked my number and called me 5 times in a row, so I finally called him back. He was speaking very slow and very calm and kept asking me to repeat things slower. I told him, he told me that he had slept with Shiloh a few days after her 17th birthday, not 16th. However, he breezed over the fact that their online relationship began when she was 16. He signed his divorce papers in front of Shiloh and, after Googling the law, slept with her. That is what I can comfortably share of that situation. She goes on to say that anyway, as we got into the conversation, I bring up his accusations of me being sexually inappropriate with him and that they were not true. I also brought up him talking about my child in his video. He lied and stated that he had never done those things, despite me having actual texts from him accusing me of them. Eventually, he was speaking in such a way that I blatantly asked Greg, are you recording me? And he very proudly stated, yes, I am. I let him know that as per the state of Washington, he has now broken a state law as well as potentially federal law by recording me without my consent. He started trying to tell me that it wasn't against the law, and I started again that he had recorded me without my consent and that he had broken the law and hung up. That's when those texts began. So that does give a little bit more context of why it started off the way that it did. She goes on to say, when I retracted my statement, I did so at the threat of being sued for slander. I asked him not to speak about me again as a contingency to his request of me retracting my statement. I also asked him not to contact me again. He then continued to text me. He also went on Drunken Peasants the following day and repeatedly talked about me despite what I asked him. Repeatedly lied about me as well as the situation, and now this video. He has not followed through on what I asked him and has now used my photo without permission. He will no longer be able to sue me for slander, so I now absolutely will be having something to say. And something to say, she had. The next part of the video starts off with, this is the ex-girlfriend of Social Repose. Onision defended her when he was being blackmailed by Social Repose. She is also the friend of Onision's ex-girlfriend, who Onision dumped repeatedly for lying, cheating, and illegal drug use. Now, this is the friend of Billie, and I'm guessing that he referred to Billie in this situation. I can't be sure, but it seems like he's talking about himself in the third person here and putting himself in a good light, saying that he helped these people, but look what bad they did to me. I'm not sure that this is a correct way to go about things. He goes on to say, this girl claims that Sarah, a girl Onision and LaineyBot first met in person when she was 16 and were only friends and remained just friends even after she turned 18, groomed the girl. He says that Ayalla, this girl, spent about a week total around Onision. Free housing, free meals, collaborating in videos, free plane ticket paid for by Onision, and knows for a fact we never did not do anything inappropriate with Sarah. In fact, she knows very well that I, Onision, was often mean to Sarah, which I have since apologized for. And he did say that he was mean to Sarah before the age of 18 and then was nice to her after the age of 18, which makes absolutely no sense to me. At all.
The grooming, that's what the question was about. So I've treated this person really badly until they turn 18. Now, I've said that repeatedly and it's very real. I called them many mean names on a regular basis. I treated them like, you know, I would treat anybody I had no interest in.
No, that doesn't make any sense, because he just said he treated this person very badly until they turned 18. That's literally child abuse. I hate to use that term. I really do. But that's what he said. He then goes on to make a very serious accusation. While this girl lies about Sarah being groomed, she leaves out the fact that she asked Sarah if Sarah would have sex with her in just the short week she was around Onision, Sarah, and Kyle. So you can understand why I regret ever flying her out. She is a liar and a pervert. Now, these are very serious accusations because there are no screenshots or any proof provided at all. In fact, this is the definition of slander. This is real slander. When everyone else was doing these videos, they did provide photographic evidence and screenshots of specific scenarios, but there are none of that existing throughout this video. And if there are screenshots provided, they are without context, unless context is provided, as we'll see. This conversation starts out, anything you have to say to me, you can say in writing. I don't know what you could possibly have to discuss with me. He says, it's okay, our lawyer will contact you. She says, looking forward to it. Then he says, Sarah very clearly asked you not to talk about her, to leave her alone. Why are you harassing Sarah? Can you please stop causing problems in her life? Additionally, Sarah has made it clear you hit on her when you were at our house. You even asked her if she would be willing to sleep with you, and these are Sarah's words, except for we don't see Sarah saying this. I keep hearing about the things you are saying, and you admitted you have brain damage, according to Sarah, who watched your live stream. I'm personally do have brain damage myself. Personally, I have brain damage, and I will tell you that it does not affect what you can or cannot do. It can sometimes make the words that you say weird, as I say a lot, just like that. That was definitely that, because my cognitive brain functioning is off a little bit, but it's healing. We're gonna get back to 100% full capacity here soon, hopefully. There's it is again, man. It's a pet peeve. Please get help for your issues and leave Sarah, who has asked you to not discuss her in any way, alone. You are harassing her and she just wants to live her life. Lastly, you will be receiving a cease to desist soon. You told me a long ago to move on and I did. Yet here you are trying to get back in all of our lives. Please take your own advice, leave Sarah alone, be happy with your own life. Thank you, get well soon. Additionally, Sarah confirmed most everything you're saying about her is a lie. I'm going to assume you are saying these things as a result of the brain damage you mentioned. I do hope you get well soon. That seemed really kind of mean. So in this segment here, you can see Ayalla is saying, please stop contacting me. Has said it 1, 2, 3, 4 times. She said it 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4. And he continues to keep on replying. There could be many different reasons why this conversation continued. She might have been saying no, I want you to stop contacting me, just because she knew it would initiate him to say more. I'm really unsure. We need more context. So I did reach out to Ayala and I got her statement on the matter. Let's get into that. She said, Greg is digging at his last straws to try to discredit the things that I witnessed of his behavior, treatment, and vulnerable young women. And even in his own home, I won't allow him to scare me into silence anymore. It's truly insane what's going on here. I have been in contact with Maya, Madison, and Haley. These girls are afraid of what he will say or do next to discredit or publicly humiliate them. I myself was afraid, but with so many girls coming forward, having also admitted they haven't spoken up to avoid public shaming from someone with millions of subscribers, I can't even imagine backing down. He knows what he's doing is wrong with all of these women, and he thinks people can turn a blind eye to it if he deflects enough. I'm doing my best right now, and I'm proud of these women for gaining courage to speak out more about what has happened to them. It's very stressful, though it took me a long time to be brave enough to take this smear and let people know he's not safe to be around. I said, I understand these kind of things are very difficult emotionally. It goes on to say that I had to wait over a year and a half for Greg to stop trying to make me look bad. Last time I spoke out about some abusive behavior towards my best friend. It's been a rough road, but there was so much more that was never shared because I didn't want to be on the front page of his YouTube painted as a degenerate. I also never tried to sleep with Sarah, but I didn't really think I needed to say that. So as you can see with the added context behind this, it makes a whole lot more sense, where even in Onision's video here, it really takes the context out. And it seems like it's all twisted towards his end, his scenario. And that's what makes it come off very disingenuous. And it makes it look just like the Streisand effect or the Avero effect, where it looks like he's hiding something. This causes YouTubers to make videos and delve deep into the scenarios and situations like me, and even had to reach out to get the statements from Ayala and Madison just to understand exactly what his video was talking about. And again, I am not trying to degrade anyone. I am literally only talking and stating the facts between these individuals and these scenarios, because if we do not have all the facts, how will we know what opinion to form? Onision goes on to say that Sarah asked the girl to stop talking about her directly, and in a response, this girl tweeted, "The plot thickens," then proceeded to live stream, exploit Sarah for personal gain despite her asking her to not speak of her. She then uploaded a YouTube version of her live stream where she made hundreds of dollars on her channel, which prior got barely any views. Now, I do want to point out this tweet. It says, "It has been requested of me to leave out the name and personal information of the young woman involved in this case. Please keep that in mind when I'm speaking tomorrow on the issue." Now, when we watched, we seen that this is the thing that she held to. So having this context in with what he just said, it really disproves what he's trying to spin here, what he's trying to say. And I want to point out the fact that without the context, without the proper receipts, this is slander on Onision's part by definition. Now we're going to go and watch the public statement that Sarah released on Onision's channel, which is very skeptical, and I know a lot of people are not believing this because it was indeed posted on Onision's channel. I'm going to point out some critical errors within this, and I'm not trying to say that she is a liar.
Hello everyone, my name is Sarah, and recently I've seen some allegations against my friend Kai regarding me. And I just came.
I do want to say that when she says Kai, she is speaking of Laney, and she is referring to him as he, because I've made this mistake in my last couple of videos. I believe Laney is identifying as non-binary. Is that correct? Please correct me if I'm wrong in the comments below.
To make my statement, since I see a lot of people talking for me, but people are saying that we had sexual conversations or were planning on having sexual relations when I was underage, and we never did.
I do want to say that she said they never had these types of conversations, and if that's true, then what is this? This is a text from Sarah saying she's about to take a shower, Laney saying without me, winky face, she's saying yeah. And then she says, "What would you do if I was there?" That seems very sexual in nature. And I do provide in the video in the description multiple screenshots of this same type of behavior, and that's why the internet was so concerned in the very first place. Sarah goes on to say in this video,
I don't know why people are now saying this and bringing up old screenshots that have already been addressed, but Kai is one of the sweetest people I know, and he doesn't deserve this, and it's not fair to me, and it's not fair to him, and I wish this would all stop.
So that was her statement, and as I said, a lot of people were really skeptical of this, and I don't think anybody is saying that she's a liar. No one wants to come out and say that she's a liar or anything like that. That's not what this is about. We're just comparing the evidence to what she's saying, and that's what does not add up, and you have to understand. This is another screenshot that was majorly concerning to me. So this is a screenshot that was sent by Madison. This is from Madison to Sarah. I believe it's one of the only conversations they had. It's from 3/27 of 2015, 5:53 p.m. You're going to see Madison in the blue saying, yikes, lol. So how do you know Lainey? Met her on Twitter, then our mutual friend Regina told her that she could trust me, so Lainey kicked me her number. Red, yup, lol. Who's Regina? Regina, Lainey's friend for 2 years. That's awesome. How old are you and Regina? We're both minors. Little ones, how old? Psh, not that little. I'm legal in less than a year and a half, so 16. That's the age of consent in Washington. Just seeing if it was the same in Michigan. So that's pretty crazy. Why do they even bring up age of consent laws? They are both minors and they were both talking to Lainey. Now I do want to point out these are both allegations, but I felt they were important to provide as context towards the video. As you can see, none of these things that he's saying are backed up with any sort of evidence, and the evidence that he did provide in this video again was without context, and I hope that you can better make sense of it out of everything now that I have provided the context with it. If you do have any questions, all you got to do is reach out to me in social media. We are trying to build up that Instagram. We just passed 5,000 followers. Now I'm on the road to 10,000 followers, so it's the.repzilla. Going to do a Q&A over there. I do want to point out that all of these things are allegations and nothing is proven in a court of law, but if it ever was to move towards that, I think it would be interesting to see how it unfolds. And I do personally believe that that's where this is headed and where it should rightfully go. But I want to know what you think about this, because as interesting as this is, also it's more interesting to me. That's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think. So why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below. Thumbs up. And as always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. Whew. Well, I did reach out to Ayala, and I had her to tell me what her name, how her name is pronounced. It goes like this. Hold on.
My name is Ayala, but the easiest way to learn it is you say Ayaya, Ayala.
Ayaya, Ayala, Ayala. I just feel like my southern accent is going to have a really hard time figuring that out, but I'll do my best to do that. Because I know that you're ripping. If you're not ripping, Greg, and how do you do that? All you gotta do is subscribe, notifications turned on, be in the comment section to every single video, because I'm gonna be there, Greg the Cat's gonna be there, and the rest of the Repzion community as well. And I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you.
My favorite thing to do is eat. I love food.